I'm just going to do a tutorial today on how to record a macro for repetitive actions. So basically I'm completing this form, and it's a fill-in form that people are going to come into a pile of items. I only have two on each table right now, and they're going to be selecting four items, 1, 2, 3, or not applicable. And I want them to be able to see what each of those items mean. Like it says here, 1, mild or rarely occurring, 2, moderate or rarely occurring, etc. So each one means something. And it'll make more sense as I go along with the tutorial why I would like to record a macro instead of typing everything for every item. I have about 6 pages to create here, and they're all going to have exactly the same thing. So it just doesn't make sense to keep typing it over and over. And that's what a macro does. It records keystrokes. And so what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to use quick keys to do the actions instead of using your mouse. And another thing that you're going to want to do is I'm going to assign 2 quick keys for this macro. So I'm going to try that quick key combination right now. I'm going to use Alt Shift and Y. So I press those 3 buttons and nothing happened. The reason you want to do that is because although the macro tells you if something is currently assigned or not, sometimes it says it's available and it's actually not. That has happened to me and I'm not sure why. So make sure you try your quick key combination that you're going to assign to your macro before you go in to start recording your macro. Okay? So the first thing you want to do is you want to get this developer tab on. Now I'm just going to click into my table to show you that now that I'm in the table, I get this table tools tab. But when I'm out of that table, those disappear. Okay, so if you do see that when I'm in the table and you don't have it, it's because you don't have a table. So to get the developer tab to turn on, what you're going to do is you're going to go into the file folder over here. And you're going to go down to options. And then what you're going to do is you're going to come all the way down here to the customize ribbon. The quick key for moving down is using your down arrow key. And then I have a choice of using my tab key, which will toggle you through. But it will take me from here to here to here to here. The fastest way, because I want to get all the way over here, is you'll notice that we have an underlined letter. You'll notice that each one of these items, the C is underlined here, has an underlined letter. We have the T here. So basically what you want to do is you want to use that Alt key and the underlined letter to get to where you want to go. Sorry about that. I'm locked up because of where I am. I'm going to go back to that customize ribbon. So it's the Alt key and B. Why aren't we working? Just 1 second. I'm going to go back up to general. I'm going to use that and then I'm going to use the Alt B. There we go. Now it's working. Not quite sure what I was doing wrong, but normally you would be typing your quick keys so quickly that that doesn't happen. I find that if I have used my mouse, that's when I get a lot of the dinging going on. So I'm just going to take the, and first of all, I'm going to minimize this to show you that if you are in here and you don't have these, it's probably because your this is not opened up. Okay, so that's how those work. If you didn't have the developer tab, you will have a blank box in developer. You take your mouse, you'll click in there, and then click OK, and then you will have that developer tab. Okay, so back to quick keys again, the Alt key, and you'll get all of these tiles. And what that is that letter is the quick key to get into that tab. So instead of having to use your mouse, you can leave your hands on the keyboard. So to get into page layout, for instance, right here, you'll see that there's a P there. I press the P, and then I have tiles underneath each of my options as well. So if I wanted to get into the margins, I would press the M and it would take me into the margins. And if I wanted to customize the margins, you'll notice way down here that the A is the underlined letter, and also there's the tile A. So I press A and here I could customize my tiles. If I wanted to get into from margins over to paper, I could use my my tab key, or I could click with my mouse or get into the layout. Okay, so that's how the quick keys work, and it's best to use the quick keys with recording macros because it's just a lot faster, and that's what it does. It basically records the keystrokes. Okay, so I'm going to press the Alt key one more time. You will not have all of these on your screen, and the reason that you won't is that I customized my quick access toolbar. Now I'm just going to click over here. You will have this line with the triangle, but it will be up over here. And the reason that it will be is that by default it's there, and I believe it has these three icons by default, and you can click on those tools to undo, save, or do the spell check faster than going into the tab that it is within your ribbon. So that's why I have created my quick access toolbar, so that I don't have to go into each one of these to use these tools that are on the quick access toolbar. And I do have a tutorial on how to do that. And I like my quick access toolbar close to my workspace. I just find it easier for it to be there. Now, to change where your quick access toolbar is, you would right click on the line and triangle, and you'll notice way down here at the bottom it says show above ribbon. Mine says show above ribbon because it's below the ribbon, and the ribbon is this area here. So if my quick access toolbar was up here, which it is by default, it would say show below the ribbon. So it's like a light switch. Wherever your ribbon is, that this is going to be the opposite to allow you to change where it is. Okay, so I'll link a description to that tutorial if you are interested in doing that. So we'll get back to the recording of the macro now. So basically, you want to be in the position where you're going to be creating your contents for your macro, and I'm creating it for all of the items in this column. And then what you want to do is you want to get into that developer tab. So I'm going to do the Alt key, and Al is under developer right here. You'll see Al is under developer. So I'm going to press Al, and then what I'm going to do is I am going to press R over here for record macro. Okay, so then this box pops up, and what you want to do is you want to give that macro a name. So I'm going to call it macro Dropbox. And then what I want to do is I want to get down, I'm going to do the Alt D for description to get down into this area, and I'm going to give a description as to what this macro does, because if I don't use it often, I'm going to forget what it does. So adds Dropbox goes into properties, don't forget to fill tag and title. This will make sense once we do it. Completes Dropbox entries, and adds a field code. And all of this will make sense when we record the macro. I'm going to do an Alt K to get into the keyboard because I want to make a keyboard quick key. If you're a mouser, you'll want to add a button. Okay, so I'm going to do Alt K, and then I'm going to, in here, I'm going to depress the keys that I'm going to assign to this quick key, which were Alt Shift and Y. And you'll see down here currently assigned to, it says unassigned. And like I said, you want to do that test before you create this quick key, because you don't want to take away the quick keys from another tool that you may have assigned them to. So I'm just going to say assign down here on the left hand side. I could do the Alt A, but I'm going to press with the mouse. And then I press close. And now you'll notice, I'm just going to move my mouse around to bring attention to it, to the cursor, that the arrow pointer has a record button on it saying that from this point forward, I'm going to record your keystrokes. So I'm going to put that Dropbox in by going Alt L for developer, Alt O. I now have my Dropbox in there. And now I'm going to put in the go to the property box, which is Alt L L. This is where the title and tag is going to be different for every item. So I'm just going to tab through those. I'm going to say use a style format, and then I'm going to pick the style. I created this style, and if you don't know how to do that, I can do a separate tutorial on how to create your own styles, custom styles. And so then what you want to do is, if you'll see locking here, I do not want someone to be able to delete anything in my form. So I'm going to do an Alt D to put a check mark in there. Now I do want my contents to be edited, so I'm not going to check that off. And now I'm going to do an Alt A just to show you something. You'll notice that I'm up in tag. My cursor is blinking up in tag because when Word created this, they put an Alt A here and also an Alt A over here where add is. So then I'm going to say add, and this is where I'm filling in the choices that they're going to pick from. And you don't want to have any mistakes here, so pay attention to what you're doing. I'm going to tab through there. I'm going to say okay. Then I'm going to add again. Two is, and you want to be consistent, moderate, rarely. Three is severe, often. I'm going to use that tab key. And then not applicable. And then I'm going to use my tab key to get to the OK button and press enter. And then now what I want to do is I also want to add the field code so that they can toggle through to each question. So that's Alt L, and then that's N and E. And now we have a field code in there. So basically I have every single thing that I wanted recorded, and I don't have to go through that process. You'll see in a second. So I say stop recording. So one of the things that I forgot to mention when I was showing you how to record that macro was that you may want to go into the properties box and deal with the tag and title. So I'm just going to click into design mode, and you'll see that we have the two boxes here, and go into the properties box. And remember, we did not fill out the title and the tag. Now, sometimes in a form, you will not see what you're choosing, your item for. So I'm just going to go out of, so I can show you what I mean. So if I'm clicking on this drop box, I don't know what I'm choosing, mild, moderately, or severe, or NA sometimes. In this case, I do. So I don't really need to do this step, and I'm not going to on this form. But I'll show you what you should do if you can't see what your choices are. Okay, so we'll go back into design mode, and you'll see we have these boxes here. And we're going to go into the Alt L L for the properties box. The properties box is right here below design mode. And here we have the title and the tag, and I'll show you what happens. We'll call it gas because that's what the item number one is here, is gas. Okay. So we're going to call it gas, and we're going to tag it as gas, and we're going to say okay. And now you'll notice that this item, even if we go out of design mode up here at the top, it has that you're talking about gas, and that would make it easy for somebody to know what they were dealing with. If they were filling in the form, they might say, oh, what was my question again? And that way they could look up and know that it was gas. But I'm not going to like you could do that for each one. So I'm just going to go back into design mode and do that again. So you could go into this one and do your Alt L L to bring up that property box. And in the title, I would say bloating, bloated, Well, it doesn't matter. You can say bloating or bloated. And then we'll say okay. And now we have bloated here. But they don't have to do that, because when they're filling out the form, when we're not in design mode, we can see exactly what we're dealing with here. Okay?